Hello and welcome to the Num2Bars demo. Num2Bars is a utility font that has been developed by Christoph Almaschi and René Andrich. We developed the font because we felt the need to create bar graphs with more precision in an easy way. This font covers one decimal, so it covers the range from 0 to 100%. For this font, we tried to focus only on the essentials, so we only included numbers from 0 to 9, a comma, and a period, because that's all we need to create those bars. So let's go to the first example. Depending on the language you use, you might want to use a comma or a period for your numbers. I zoom in a little bit. So for instance, in German, this would be like 37,2, or for English text, you want to do it like 49.5. Num2Bars uses the OpenType feature called discretionary ligatures. So the only thing we have to do is select text. Then in InDesign, for instance, go up to the menu right here to OpenType and turn on the discretionary ligatures. And as the font name suggests, the numbers turned into bars. So that would be the most simple of applications. You can, of course, use it horizontally, or if you like, also just turn it 90 degrees. Then you have a bar chart that is upright. Now you might ask yourself how to edit the numbers. That's also quite easy. Either you go back, select everything, and turn off the OpenType feature discretionary ligatures. Though that would be a little bit cumbersome, going back and forth all the time. So I turn those back on. I hit Command or Control Y to open the story editor and start editing the numbers. For instance, this one to 52.1. And as you just saw, the period or the comma are important because those trigger the discretionary ligatures. So if you don't use a comma or a dot, then you will only have the numbers that are provided by the typeface. So let's type in 52.6 again, and you can see the bars adjusted accordingly. The convenient thing with this is that as it is a font, you can just select everything, edit the leading so you can get less space between the bars. You can, of course, select it and give it a color of your choice or different colors. To make it even simpler, you could also put everything into a paragraph style, and I already prepared some in this document. Having the text box selected, I go to the paragraph style panel, turn the bars off for now, so we get numbers again, and also for the sake of clarity, I will put them into black color. And now I have a second paragraph style, which is called bars on, and if I click it, it just turns into bars, and the only thing I did with this one, I'd go and edit it. You can see in the open type features, I turned on the discretionary ligatures. So if I turn those off again, you can see with the preview activated that I only get the numbers. I cancel out of it. So this would be the two simplest examples. You already spotted it maybe. There I have a paragraph style that is called stacked bars with three colors. With some InDesign trickery, it's also possible to create stacked bars, and let's have a look at that in the second example. Here we have four items, and these four items have been evaluated in three categories, and the three categories add up to 100%. So if we want to show them as a stacked bar, we can use some InDesign features that will allow us to do that. Right now, when I go into the text box, the font is still in Calibri, so let's change that to Num2Bars. I just click the paragraph style bars off, because that will change the font to Num2Bars. So now we have our numbers. And to show you that they are still separated, I simply click the bars on paragraph style so that the numbers are converted into bars. That's the first step. We want to get rid of the spaces in between there. I will first show you how it looks when it works. So I just click the paragraph style stacked bars, three colors. They nicely stack on top of each other and even have different colors. To make that work, we employ two InDesign features that are helpful in any project. Let's edit the paragraph style and I show you what they are. The first thing I show you is the so-called nested styles. And these nested styles, which I have applied here, will make sure that every bar gets a separate color. So here you can see color one through one words. That's how you can define it. There are even more things you can select here, but for this example, we just stick with that as it works right out of the box. Nested styles always work with character style, so I had to define those character styles first. And that character style only holds which color is applied to the characters. Color 1 corresponds to color 1 in the swatches panel, color 2 and color 3 respectively. The second thing to make this work is the grab style, and this is a very much underused feature but a very powerful one. With that feature you can define certain characters or even non-characters, like in this case, and how they should be treated. So I defined a character style that is called stacked, and in that character style I defined that the kerning should be -1000, and it is applied to an EM space, which is exactly 1000 units wide, and that's why they cancel out each other and remove the space between the bars. So that's the abbreviation for that. I can go into this menu, and when I go to white spaces, you can see EM space, and that's what I inserted here. I cancel out of it. I quickly turn the bars off so you can see how it looks without the open type and ligature features. For this, I will also disable the preview. And there you can see I inserted an EM space between all those numbers. If you buy a license of our font, then this document will be part of the package and you can dissect all those paragraph and character styles. I also want to show you example 3, which is an example with real life data. That data is drawn from the data reportal. You can see the link here. You can check it out if you want. It's a really nice platform that shows social media use all over the world. So here you can see the social media platforms in Austria and the percentages in which they are used. And let's make a bar graph out of that. I will also show you a nice trick for the labeling, but first let's create the bars. I will copy all the numbers because we will need them to label the bar graph. So I copy them and then paste them in place again. So let's move that over. Then I will convert those numbers from Calibri to num2bars. And as we have the num2bars numbers now, we can turn on the discretionary ligatures and get our bars. Let's do that right here. Open type, activate the discretionary ligature features. Here we are with our bars. I could also have used my paragraph style that I already defined earlier. Bars off would be that, and bars on would be that. Now also let's give them some colors. So I will also show you how it looks when the bars are off. We can color all the numbers. Let's take the orange. And as we maybe want to change the hue later on, we'll define that as a new paragraph style. New paragraph style. Bars orange. I will base it on no paragraph style. The basic character format is num2bars. I'll keep that like this. And the only thing we have to do is go to the open type features section and activate the discretionary ligatures. Just have a preview. I apply the selection also, so you can see it turns to a bar. It only does it with one bar because I had the cursor there and not everything was selected, but we'll change that after we define the style. I hit OK. So now I select my whole text and hit the paragraph style bars orange. Everything turns into bars. And maybe the only thing I want to do is I define a different orange because we already have one orange that's related to our stacked bars. So let's go in here, create a new color swatch. And maybe we just go with a darker orange, like 60%. Say OK. And then edit the bars orange again. Go down to the character color and choose the new orange. And now everything is perfectly set up. hit escape to get the bounding box of the text box again. So if we narrow down the text box like this, hit the command or control key before I start dragging, then you can also scale up those bars. And by doing that, you actually applied another feature, which can be seen here in the character section. The horizontal scale has been updated to 565%. We can do it manually here as well. So maybe let's do 800%. Now the text box is too small, just widen that up. So to finalize the design, I want to have all the type or the labeling of which social media platform inside the bars at the beginning. And I want to have those numbers aligned to the right of each bar with a little bit of a distance, let's say like 1 or 2 millimeters. First, let's move those bars over. Then I will put them into the back. I will activate this text box, select all the text, adjust the text size to 6 points. Let's also change the font weight to bold so you can read it better, and also let's do it in white. So I escape out of that, then adjust it a little bit like this. So we have these done already, and now comes the nice little trick. We also go with these. Let's take the same type size, like 6 and a leading of 14 with bold, but let's keep it in black. Escape out of that, align those two, select this as the master text box, align it at the top so now they are evenly distributed, and I want to align those numbers to the right of every bar. Of course, if you move it over there, nothing happens. So for this we have to do another step. I select the bar graph, I will copy it, paste it in place again, so I make a duplicate which will be my backup, because I have to convert the type into outlines to make the trick work. So I close the panel, open the layers panel, and create a new layer which is called backup. I'll put that below layer 1 and then move the already selected bars to that backup layer and disable the visibility. So now we have a backup of our data, and we convert these bars into outlines. I go up to the type menu and down here create outlines. Now we have this group of bars. I will ungroup those, select one of these, go up to the text wrap and activate the text wrap for one of the bars. Holding the Alt key or Option key and clicking the icon, I can dial in some more detail. So at the bottom I will go for a -1. At the right, let's take like 2 millimeters. You can see already that would be the distance to the type. Let's exit out of that. For this text box, I go to the text frame options in the object menu and ignore the text wrap so that the type is not being wrapped. But of course, for these, we want the text wrap to work, so let's try it. I push it to the left, and as you can see, the percentage of 81.6 stays in place. We also want that for all the other numbers because they still ignore the text wrap. The best thing is to create an object style for that, so I do that quickly. Create a new object style. So we keep everything as it is. We keep the fill, of course, because then we can also change the fill if you want a different color. But most importantly, the text wrap is defined here. Let's name this as bar text wrap. I hit OK. Now select all of my other bars, deselect the text box, apply the text wrap object style. You can see the text wrap has been applied. And now clicking and holding the left edge of the text box, we will interactively see what happens with the text, and every number will just stop at the respective bar. And that's how we created this bar chart.